Toy House 60, Toy House 60, it's Toy House 60.
So, the parents that I really need to talk to tonight.
Should we make a run for it?
Let's just see what she has to say. Oh, I know. Before I forget, here are some of the stuff I confiscated. One chicken. Orange slinky. One fidget spinner. One scary flashlight. One toy grabber. Another fidget spinner. Pack of playing cards. Some disgusting looking slushy. One whoopee cushion. Another fidget spinner. I don't know why these things are so popular. And one moldy bottle of mustard. These are just some of the stuff I confiscated from your son this month. Oh, I'm so sorry, teacher. I don't know why he keeps bringing this stuff to school.
Yeah, I'm really sorry. We'll definitely talk to him about this.
Very well. And please feel free to take all the stuff with you. Anyways, let's continue. Alright, let's start with Jessie-Cake. She's a very sweet kid. She has not been in trouble with me. And so far, she has perfect attendance. And she has not been tardy. In the last few weeks, she seems to be turning her homework in a little bit late. She mentioned something about some summer camp she's trying to get into. Oh yes, there's this summer program at the Chef Club for kids that does baking. And she's been working on her application to get in for the last few weeks. It's very important to her, so that's what we've been focusing on.
We'll talk to her and make sure she doesn't fall behind in her other studies.
I guess that's understandable. And I'm glad that you two are aware of what's going on. There is still a chance for her to catch up with the class and get a better grade. We will definitely help her try to catch up after all this is over. Alright then, that's all I have to say about Jessie-Cake. But overall, great kid.
That's good.
Yeah. Alright, now I have something serious to talk to you two about. We really need to talk about this.
You still want to make a run for it?
Oh, what seems to be the trouble? It's about your son, Jesse.
I'm very sorry, teacher.
We've done everything we could. Like, we even talked to experts. We don't really know what else to do.
I know there's always room for improvement, but you know, we're really trying our best.
He's always been like this. This is quite serious.
I'm very sorry. Whatever it is, he won't do it again.
Yes, we won't let him play video games for a month. There is something you need to know about Jesse. Teacher, please, anything you can do to help us. We'll do anything you say, but please do not give up on him.
We'll do anything you suggest.
Actually, let me just show you. Look at what he did to one of my assignments.
He shouldn't have done that.
Will you two please just look at this?
I'm very sorry, teacher.
Why did he do this? I'm so sorry. Your son. I'm afraid he is...
We're very sorry what Jesse did.
Is... He didn't mean to do that to your assignment. A prodigy.
What?
Did you say prodigy? Yes, I'm afraid your son might be a prodigy.
Hold on a minute. Are we talking about the same Jesse? Blue scruffy hair, slightly pudgy, bushy brows?
Jess! Yes, Jesse. Blue hair, your son. Are you sure this isn't a mistake?
Maybe you're referring to some other kid. You know these kids, they all kind of look alike.
Well, I'm pretty sure I'm talking about Jesse here.
But you said a prodigy. You mean like Einstein and like Newton and stuff?
Well, a prodigy isn't just limited to fields of science and mathematics. There's also musical prodigies, such as Mozart. He was composing music at the age of 5. And then there are sports prodigies. You probably see them on TV all the time. In your case, I believe your son may be an artistic prodigy.
So, what are you trying to say?
Prodigies are defined as kids who have professional abilities at a young age.
Jessica, is this teacher alright?
Well, I mean, he always liked to draw and stuff. I mean, he would paint in his notebooks, but he never showed much interest beyond that.
I mean, he never told us he wants to go to, like, museums or anything.
Look closely at this.
What am I looking at?
Look at the pattern of the paint splatter. It's colorful. I took a picture of this and sent it to my colleague who has a PhD in modern art. And she was quite impressed that a child was able to produce this. And I found this in his notebook.
He's done stuff like this a lot. I just thought he never grew out of finger painting.
Teacher, are you saying that this is like really good. With the right environment, he could produce some true artistic masterpieces. However, unfortunately, not all child prodigies excel through adulthood.
Okay, we've always told him he can keep drawing if he likes to, but he's never shown much interest in art beyond that.
And all those art classes that I signed him up for, he's always gotten bored and quit. It could just simply be too easy for him. You need to understand that with his level of talent, he's not gonna enjoy doing pottery and paper mache's with other kids.
But I've never heard him talk about like art or artist or anything like that.
He could just not be aware of his own true talents. Obviously, he is held back here. I know that some children who are under-challenged seems to find other ways to distress themselves, such as playing pranks.
Could this explain everything then?
Look, he is obviously bored. It is as if he is stunted in his growth. We wouldn't want to do anything to hold him back. Psychologists have long debated what creates a prodigy. It is possible that anybody could be a prodigy, but only with the right environment. For example, Mozart's father was a famous music teacher.
Well, I'm not sure if we can, like, help him with this.
And like I said, unfortunately, not all child prodigies reach their full potential nor excel through adulthood. So it is really important to nurture their talents at a young age.
So what do you suggest we do?
He gets bored wherever he goes. You can consider sending him to an art school for gifted children.
I'm not sure if we've seen those schools around here.
Where do we find those schools? My colleague did suggest a very famous one in New York City.
New York City?
And plus, New York City has a high concentration of artistic talents, so it would be a great environment. But that's thousands of miles away!
He's still a little kid.
We can't send him that far away! Well, it is one of the best in the world. I mean, it does cost $60,000 a year.
$60,000? I don't know if we can, like, even afford that.
We still need to save for, like, college. And Jessica wants to go to culinary school. So that's gonna be really expensive.
I mean, is there like another school that's more affordable?
Don't get us wrong, we want the best for our kids. And the summer camp that Jessica wants to go to, that's really expensive too. Will you two let me finish?
Oh, sorry, teacher. Sorry. Go ahead.
There is a scholarship. There is a philanthropist who wants to help talented kids reach their full potential. I believe the winner of the scholarship can have all their tuition and expenses covered for any study they choose.
Oh. We'll definitely look into that.
But Jess, I don't know if I'm ready to send him away. Why don't you guys just take your time to think about it? And don't forget to take all that stuff with you. Oh yes, teacher, thank you.
This definitely is not what I expected.
Oh my goodness, Jess. Can you believe what she said about Jesse?
Toy House 60, Toy House 60, it's Toy House 60. Comment, like, and share, and subscribe before you go. Toy House 60, Toy House 60, it's Toy House 60.